A 35-year-old Hindu female residing at Gandhidham came to ENT OPD GK General Hospital with complaint of difficulty in swallowing since 2 years. Patient was relatively asymptomatic before 2 years. Then she gradually developed difficulty in swallowing more for solid than liquid diet, which was associated with weight loss, low-grade fever, decreased appetite, throat pain, recurrent nasal discharge, which was watery and profuse in amount, associated with nasal blockage and difficulty in breathing. There were no any history of earache, bleeding from nose or any neck swelling. Patient was having past history of tuberculosis before 10 years. She has taken AKT for 6 months. Patient is also having history of surgery for nasal polyp before 3 years. Family history was significant. Personal history. Patient is having vegetarian diet, bowel and bladder were normal, sleep was normal, appetite was decreased. There was no any significant habit of. On obstetric history of patient, patient is not having any child since 12 years of her marriage life. Menstrual history, patient was having regular moderate menstruation, interval of 25 days and 4 to 5 days, which was painful in nature. On general examination, patient is malnourished and built. Pallor was seen in conjunctiva and nail bed. Clubbing is also present. Edema was absent. Ecterus and lymphadenopathy were also absent. On vitals, patient's vitals were normal. On systemic examination, GIT, there were no any abnormality. On RS examination, bilateral Krebs was present. On CVS examination, S1, S2 was heard. On CNS examination, patient was conscious and well oriented to time, place and person. On examination of ear, we found that there was decreased hearing on the left side of ear. Rest other examination findings were normal. On examination of nose, we found that there was whitish glistening polypoidal mass coming from left side nasal cavity. On examination of throat and neck, there were no any abnormality. So we planned diagnostic esophagoscopy for this patient. During blood investigation, we found that patient is having hemoglobin 9 gram. Then, due to changes of X-ray like bronchiectasis and dextrocardia and ECG changes, we ordered 2D echography for this patient, which was suggestive of dextrocardia. Patient was taken in operation theater. General anesthesia was given. On examination of esophagus, we found that there was stricture in post-cricoid region. Dilatation of this region was done with boogie. Hemostasis was achieved. Patient was brought out of general anesthesia. There were no any signs of esophageal perforation found post-operatively. So, now we came to conclusion that this patient is having Plummer-Vinson syndrome because patient is having post-cricoid web, anemia, clubbing. Along with this, we also found that patient may have Kartagener syndrome, which is composed of recurrent nasal polyposis, bronchiectasis, dextrocardia and infertility. This syndrome occurs due to ciliary dyskinesia. This is autosomal recessive disorder which occurs in approximately 1% in 30,000 births. So we should manage this patient further for bronchiectasis by mucolytics and high dose of antibiotics, and medical and surgical management should be done for nasal polyposis.